again on collectivelybeautiful.com. We are here today with the beautiful and charismatic Shaharah.
Aww, thanks, girl.
Of course, I've been a fan since day one, since I saw you perform.
Thank you.
So much energy, so much love. So I wanted to share your story with everyone.
Thank you.
So first, where do we start? When did you decide you wanted to be a singer?
When did I decide I wanted to be a singer?
That's
a difficult question to answer. I always wanted to be a singer since I was very, very young. I was always singing, loved watching musicals, loved performing for my family, with my family, but really made a decision to pursue it as a full-time career 2 years ago.
2 years ago?
2 years ago.
Oh, wow. And since then, you've been everywhere. You've toured a little bit. I know when I first heard about you, you were in Japan.
Oh, yes. Yes, I did some
I did my homework.
You go, girl. Yeah, actually, I'm looking at releasing my album in Japan. So that's why I was there for some business meetings. So I'm well.
Very cool. So that's your first album.
Yeah.
What are your expectations?
Well, I've only released an EP, so it's like a 6-track album. So it's a short version of the album to come.
Okay.
And I've released it online so far, so it sells on iTunes. And then I sell like sort of promotional copies of the EP on my shows. So it does really, really, really well. I'm very proud of it.
Okay, very cool. And what inspires you?
Inspires me. It's hard to stay motivated, especially at this point of my career, because it's a lot of work, not a lot of return financially. So I actually play here at the Spray Bar every Thursday from 9:30 to 11:30, and that sort of just remotivates me and reminds me of why I love what I do so much, and that this is what I'm meant to do, and it just helps me to sort of keep stepping, you know, keep going forward, even when it seems really tough or impossible to get where I'm going to.
And you were just saying that there's a few obstacles. What would you recommend for anyone who inspires to be a singer?
I would say that we have to be sure, first of all, that that's what you want to do. And I mean, with anything you choose to do in life, it's always going to be a difficult, there's always going to be obstacles. So I think you really have to make up your mind and decide that that's what you want to do, regardless of what gets thrown your way, that you're going to find a way to get around it or over it or through it. I mean, that's pretty much it.
Okay, so to...
I would say to really be sure that that's what you're passionate about, that's really what you want to do.
Yes. Okay. I find that that's a reoccurring role in a lot of people who are sure about their career. They always say you have to have a lot of passion for it, because at first, it's never easy.
No. With anything that you choose to do in life, it's never easy. So you gotta be sure that's what you love, that's what you want.
Okay. So in the past 2 years, since you decided to, you know, pursue this professionally, what has been the highlights?
So beautiful there.
Wow, I've done so much in the last 2 years. I'm really, really proud of what I've accomplished in the last 2 years. I have shot in 2 videos. One that's already been released, that's doing really well. And the second one, which I actually just got the final copy of this morning, that I will be releasing this week. I recorded and released a single that played all across Canada that did extremely well. I did a huge EP launch in Toronto, really, really well received, great attendance. And I also tour with this organization called White Tiger. And what they do is sort of inspire and empower young girls ages 14 to 18. And basically we teach them about all the different types of abuse, how to recognize them, how to get, you know, out of an abusive situation, and, you know, how to sort of discover what your passions are and, you know, to pursue them in life and what your local resources are and stuff like that. So yeah, I've done so much in the last 2 years. It's really been an incredible 2 years.
That leads me to my next question. I've seen you perform a few times, and on stage you look so confident and so secure in yourself and in your place. You own the stage pretty much. So where does all that confidence come from? I feel like that's really important, especially for young girls who are trying to, you know, get to know themselves.
Where does that confidence come from? Since I started performing on my own with my band, I really came into who I am as an artist and sort of discovered my style, what I'm comfortable with, what songs I'm most comfortable singing. So I would say it was really fronting the band that helped me do that. Whereas before, we were three singers. So we sort of like, you know, shared the show. We each did the equal amount of songs. But now that I'm by myself with the band, you know, I've been forced to sort of, you know, lead the band when I want to stop the song, when I want to start the song, when I want to bring it down, when I want to bring it up. So I've learned really how to like dig deep and pull whatever's inside of me and be able to perform it. So I think what we are and who we are is really inside. It's just being in a situation with people that support you and feel comfortable enough to be able to bring it out. I think that's really what it's about.
And do you feel that it's hard to balance it all, to balance this, the social life, the entertainment life, and the shows, and putting on the show for people, and then the personal, more intimate side?
It's really tough. Balancing everything in my life right now is really, really difficult. Finding the time to sleep is really difficult. Finding the time to take care of myself, to spend time with my family, has been really, really difficult, because I feel like I'm constantly working. It's like I have my own business, essentially.
Right.
And so I feel like I'm always working. If I go out for dinner, I'm networking with the people at the table beside me, you know? When I should be taking breaks in between my sets, I'm busy, you know, networking, meeting people, handing out my card, you know, talking about my next steps, what I want to do. So it's hard to sort of like turn off my brain and just relax. I found that really, really difficult in the last 2 years.
So now that it's been 2 years and your EP is out, you have already one single out and another one that we can look forward to soon.
Yes.
What's next? What should we expect from Shaharah?
Well, I'm really excited to release the second video. So I'll be releasing that. Probably have a launch tomorrow, right here, as a matter of fact,
okay.
At 9:30.
Nice.
And I'll probably be releasing a third single sometime this summer. And right now I'm in studio recording, so people should be looking forward to the full-length album that should be out by the end of this year.
Oh, perfect.
So, exciting stuff.
Good stuff. So this is an exclusive. We'll be the first one to know when the next single comes out.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much for making the time and for the wonderful advice. Hopefully it will inspire other young girls to take a leap of faith and follow their passion.
I hope so.
Thanks. Thank you for joining us on collectivelybeautiful.com.
I'm up with my phone, come on, it's the club, I'll be gone.